All right. I love graphing conic sections. I don't know about you. Love it. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to take a look at this graph here today. We're going to try and plot this graph on our screen here. Anyone know what kind of conic section this is today? Yeah.
Why do I need this in my real life?
This?
Yeah.
Why do you need this in your real life?
Why?
The conic section stuff?
Why?
You serious?
Why? I don't
you serious?
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you asked. Well, it's just, you know, you may use conic sections. If you go into certain fields of career, you may use conic sections. You may not. You may not. It just depends. But what if, you know, what if someday you want to meet the wizard?
What wizard?
The wizard.
The wizard.
The wizard. Haven't you ever seen Wizard of Oz?
Yeah.
You guys seen Wizard of Oz? You know that scene? You know that scene where Dorothy and the whole crew goes in and they got the witch's broomstick and they're talking to the wizard and basically let me show it to you. All right. Because I think this relates a lot to mathematics, actually, and why we learn math. So I want to show you something here. All right. Let me turn this up. I can't. So how does this relate to your question? Well, let me tell you. So in this movie, the wizard is like this magical being. I mean, the whole town of Oz, they'd have no idea what this thing is. This is magical. It's amazing. It's wonderful. And they all think it's the most powerful thing, an amazing thing. In our life today, we have a lot of wizards. Things that seem magical, seem amazing, that just seem like, how does this ever work? Things like Google search. I mean, you type in something into Google search, and it expands out in a second across the entire vast amount of information on the web and comes back with this nice ordered list of images and videos and everything like that. I mean, magic. It's like the Oz or the cell phones we have in our pockets. If we can go anywhere in the world and all of a sudden get reception, I can call someone across the world right now and, in fact, get their video across the thing. I mean, it's Oz. It's magic. A little while back, I remember that NASA put a Land Rover on Mars. I mean, and we've got pictures from Mars coming back. Amazing. It's like Oz. It's the wizard. And like the movie, it was interesting. We found out that the wizard, it wasn't really magic. There was a man behind the curtain who was controlling it all along. It was a secret. No one knew it. There was a man behind the curtain who was pushing the levers and pushing the buttons to make this Oz magical work. And it's interesting because in our society today, you know who's behind the curtain? It's mathematics. Mathematics lives behind the curtain in our society today. If you think about something amazing like Google search, it's not magic. Look behind the curtain. It's mathematics. Mathematics is there driving the way, pushing the buttons. If you think about those cell phones or Facebook and things that just seem, there's a lot of things there, but look behind the curtain. One of the biggest players behind the curtain is mathematics. And it's pretty cool to think about. The more math we know, we start learning this language of who's behind the curtain. We're meeting this force behind the curtain that drives so much of the neat things that we do every day. In fact, I gave you that Google search analogy. Let me share something with you that I found online here. So pretty interesting, if you think of Google search and what you do. You ever think about what happens when you push enter on Google search? Take a look at this for a second. All right, so you push it, and here's some representations explaining some of the things that happen with matrix and linear algebra to try and rank pages to figure out what pages are the best rankings here. We go through, we see matrices and formulas, we see inequalities here, all sorts of symbols, notations, and formulas, and things, and calculations going on, and summations and things, trying to rank these pages and go through. It's just incredible that every time that we go through and do that, behind the curtain, mathematics is active and pushing buttons and pulling things, going through. And I just want to encourage us to think, well, why learn math? Well, Someday we may want to meet the wizard. We want to know who's behind that curtain, understand who's pushing the buttons, and who knows where that may lead us in the future.